Welcome back, everyone. You've finally gotten the tree and all that torn wrapping paper out to the curb, but there is a whole house yet to be organized. Clearing the clutter is consistently among the most commonly made New Year's resolutions. And to help you get going and stay on task, Karen Dahl of Organizing Madison back with us today. Karen, great
Thanks
to see
for
you.
Having me.
Okay. 90% of New Year's resolutions, apparently, right? Statistically,
this is what I hear.
Broken by February.
February, right.
So the piles stay.
Yes.
Throughout the house.
Yes.
You know, I would think one of the most, and speaking from experience, I know one of the most daunting tasks of clearing the clutter is just getting started.
It is.
Look at
it
all
really
that stuff.
It really is a tough task to start.
Okay, so where do you start?
Well, set specific goals. If you just say, I'm going to get organized this year, you're not going to know where to begin. And so really set specific goals, break down tasks. You know, whether it's I'm going to work on my desk today or I'm going to work on this file drawer, start small. Little attainable goals is really the key.
See, I had a friend come over, and we did room by room and put sticky notes in each room exactly where things needed to be done.
It's a great
just
idea.
Go through and cross off the list.
Absolutely.
It worked really well. Okay, commit to the project.
Yes, commit to it. Don't just stop halfway through because it's going to get worse again.
So what, like take a whole day, a whole weekend?
What I really suggest is, again, breaking it down. And even if you can only commit 10 or 15 minutes in a day, it really does make a difference. Don't give up just because you don't have 3 hours to spend on it.
Okay. And this is what I was just talking, enlist help.
Absolutely.
So hire someone.
Either hire someone or, you know, family and friends are great too, as long as they'll be honest with you. Sometimes it's good to have an outside opinion to really give you a realistic view of what you have and what you should keep and what you should get rid of.
Having someone else come into your house and say, oh, come on, do you really need this?
It's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
It's kind of eye-opening.
Yes.
Simplify your life.
Yes. The less stuff you have, the less there is to organize. And it really, as we were talking earlier, it really lightens your load if you don't have as much stuff to worry about.
I've been on a mission to do this,
yes.
And it's made the biggest difference.
Yes. So really commit to yourself to get rid of the things you don't use and you don't love and to stop bringing things into your house. Really think twice before you buy something new, because if you don't need it and you're not going to use it, why bring it into
the house?
It
can be hard, though. There are a lot of people that really like to be surrounded by a lot of clutter or things that, you know, remind them of someplace or make them feel happy, a lot of photos.
Yeah, and I think sometimes that's a false sense of comfort, and sometimes letting it go really just lets your mind go, too, and makes everything more at ease.
So that seems simple. What is your best piece of advice, though, for someone who's really having a hard time getting started?
Again, find somebody to help you and really just take little steps and get started. It won't happen on its own, that's for sure. And it does take maintenance. I'm not saying if you get organized, your life's going to be totally easy, but it really does free up a lot of time.
And then just, you know, keep it on your to-do list to stay on top
Absolutely.
Of it.
Absolutely. Every Otherwise. Day, try to do a little bit.
Okay. Karen Dahl, always great to see you. Happy
Thanks
2011 to
yeah.
you. We really appreciate your insight.